Big Apple, as you know, still works as a real estate proposition. My next guest is building Madison Square Park with his new luxury tower. It's a stone's throw away from a lot of, let's say, the new hot tech offices. The super wealthy called it One Madison. We'll have another choice in that building. Bruce Eichner is here. He is the founder and the chairman. Bruce, very glad to see you here. Congratulations on this building. It's pretty cool. It's going to be a standout in that neighborhood.
You've got a 65-story, 777-foot-tall building designed by Cohn Pedersen Fox. Pretty cool.
It's pretty cool, and it's there, and in theory, we'll be catering to this whole new techerati, right?
Well, I think it's not only the techerati. It's actually, I think you're going to see people from One Madison Park next door want to move to something bigger, newer, fresher. It's, the Flatiron District is probably one of the two hottest areas in the city. It's really central because much of the city's moved downtown. Tribeca, Soho, Meatpacking, Highline, and this is right in the center of all of it. So it's 12 minutes south, 12 minutes north.
And is it true that J-Lo is in the area?
So it's rumored to be.
So it's rumored to be. That's very diplomatic of you, Bruce, and maybe even a Clinton or two from what we've heard. So it's certainly a desirable address. That's new to have that kind of building there. Harlem as well, you have a project there.
You know, it's interesting. I'm actually building in each of the two neighborhoods, Harlem and 22nd Street, Flatiron, the two tallest buildings in each area. So 45 East 22nd Street will be the tallest building in the Flatiron District. And in Harlem, on the corner of 125th and Park Avenue, the tallest building in Harlem is 17 stories. This will be 32 stories, which means that you will see the park, the river,
just the whole view.
Not
and
right.
It's kind of interesting, too, because that's an area that's changed a lot. And I have a lot of friends kicking themselves that they haven't bought up there. So it might be too late, because if you're there, it probably means it's too late for the average person. One thing I want to ask you, though, actually, the New York Times did a piece about a week and a half ago on a saturation point, a certain price point. And that is to say between 3 and 5 million and then say 17 million. And the point that was referenced is that 17 million and higher sells. It just sells. There's no problems. But this middle rich, I don't know what you call it officially, there's a lot of properties like that. To what extent are you concerned?
Well, first of all, not concerned because we basically have most of the product in the building is single digit millions.
And which you feel like is not saturated.
No, but it's not even just a question of saturated, Deirdre. What it really comes down to is this. People are interested in a neighborhood, then they're interested in views, then they're interested in amenities. The buildings that are starting to have problems have a view of nothing, are smaller, therefore their amenity packages are limited. The maintenances are higher. So it's not just a function of, quote, the price point. It's what are you offering? If anything, what's happened is as buyers start to have choices, they start to be a little more discriminating.
Which is understandable. Value counts in any business. So Bruce Eichner, thank you so much. Glad to see you again. Continuum Company founder and chairman. Quick, our daily.